One of the things I really wanted to do after I got this machine, considering that it's got a bobbin full of thread, was to see if I could figure out how to use it for free motion quilting. And for you quilters out there that use your sewing machines to quilt your projects, you can understand why not having to change bobbins, fill bobbins, mess around with that as often would be really nice. And so what I've done, I couldn't find a darning foot for this machine very easily, and maybe one doesn't exist, I don't know, but I, being the cheapo I am anyway, I decided I was going to try and make something to mimic a darning foot, and I came up with this. It's a paper clip that I've shaped to function as a free motion darning foot. And as it turns out, it works very well. I'll kind of show you it under in action here, and it how it does. It's been working just as well as any other darning foot on any of my other machines, so I'm pretty happy with it. So I'm gonna do a little bit of free motion here, and I'll show you. Okay, I've got my nitrile gloves on. That's what I use for my quilting gloves. And I've got a piece of sandwich here, quilting sandwich, cotton batting. And I'm going to show you how this little cheapo paper clip darning foot works for me with this two spool. I go down in there and pull my thread through underneath first. Got my feed dogs down. Not my feed dogs, my presser foot. And my feed dogs are set at zero, or close to the smallest stitch that I can set this at. So I'm not fighting the feed dogs while I'm moving things around. And I'm just gonna do something real simple so you can see how this machine works for free motion with my cheapo paper clip. Do something real simple. I'm not the best free motion quilter. We need to practice a lot, but try to do some things here. Maybe how it works. Stop for a second, get my thread out of the way. That was my starting thread. As you can see, it seems to work fairly well. I haven't done a project with this yet. I'm anxious to get something done that I can free motion with this. But you can see the advantages of that two spool. And there it is. Nothing fancy, but it works. Underside is just as good or just as bad as far as me being able to do this. So this was just my cheapo solution to be able to use my two spool for free motion quilting. Hey, I want to show you what this foot looks like off the machine, in case you want to attempt making one of these yourselves, which I highly recommend if you got any little bit of a skill for creating something like this. As you can see, it's just a curled up, bent up paper clip. And, you know, I first off kind of shaped it to the size and shape of my original presser foot. And kind of had to fiddle with it when I was putting it off and on to bend it to the right place and stuff and get it so it would work right. And it works quite well. You know, as you can tell, it's very cheap, kind of junky looking, but it works. And real happy with it so far. So I think anyone can make one of these. I'll get some close-ups of it here a little better. Not pretty, but it works. Okay, I wanted to try and show you my cheapo foot a little closer. And that's it. And as you kind of see, it's just a bent up paper clip. Seems to hold its shape pretty well, surprisingly. But that's all there is to it. Of course, I slide it on from the back since I have that loop there. And I also, another tip on it, you might make sure this little end clip is up away from the surface of the fabric when it's going, because that way it won't catch on the fabric. I almost have it even with it, but pretty close to being up out of the way. And there you have it. Simple, cheap, and whatever.